come in front right now. We got this back. That's right. So Saturday nights at sometime during the night, like on some channel, like this show comes on.
I do anything for cookies.
This is a song about Gad being Gad and doing the things that Gad do. just distended. Distended.
No.
Hi, how you doing?
Alright, how are you doing?
What's your name, little boy?
Jackie.
What's your middle name?
William.
What's your last name?
Satan!
Only one Satan, though.
Number two.
Excellent.
You said he was number two?
We'll call him the train conductor. conductor... I forgot what his first name was. Jackie.
Jack.
William. Satan. Got it.
Wasn't George Carlin the conductor?
So is Ringo Starr, man.
Yeah. That dude didn't look like either of them.
No. He didn't look like no conductor I've ever seen.
I thought he looked like Bob Lonsberry.
Lonsberry. Soon, Lonsberry, this is where you'll be. Public access with me, Pisspot the Rabbit. In between me, the sci-fi show, the stupid reggae show. Well, no, the reggae show's good. The stupid ska show.
You don't like ska?
I love cookies. And some religious show with the guy who talks to the kids.
They don't forget.
Yeah, fuck.
Hustle Simmons, yo, is great.
The lawnmower guy.
I only have heard you talk about the lawnmower guy, so once I see him, I'll acknowledge his existence on. And Miss Sweet Potato Pie, let's not forget.
Miss Sweet Potato Pie.
I like the sound of that already.
So one of our Galactus brethren.
I'm not into the marsupial, he's into the marsupial.
I know.
Right.
It's a new line of video I'm putting out.
Right. But I use mommy instead of, I like the hot little mommies.
Right.
They're like the rabbits, they reproduce too, man. Little mommies, get available every now and then, did you enjoy the show? You didn't even say nothing about the fucking show.
Yeah, it was alright. What the
fuck? What the fuck? It's alright.
It's true. It's like, yeah. What do you expect?
There's
another one.
You want to?
We'll call him Ruffles.
Whoa! Formal wear, man.
Ruffles didn't like that.
Ruffles has ridges.
Ruffles does have ridges.
That's what happens when you get on the cookies. Stuff just slips out.
Oy, Christ. Ruffles.
As ridges. What a dip.
Let's see, there was Ruffles. There was
Sweaty Pants.
Mesh Cap.
Sweaty pants.
Yeah, he's the same guy.
Mesh Cap, Sweaty
Pants.
Bad tie. Diddy Mo. Wow. You number 10.
Hey, you got any more of those fucking cookies?
What do you think?
I love these fucking cookies, man.
You want another cookie, man?
What's in them cookies?
Nah, the sugar. Spice.
That's what the government said. Sugar pill.
Yeah. Sugar pill. It's a sugar cube, dude.
Sugar cube.
Remember?
Where the fuck's Ridges, man?
Dude, man.
Oh.
It's Ruffles.
Listen,
man.
They're playing all random and discordant. They're like fish on cookies. I think they are fish.
Is it
them? Open that door, man.
Is it the radio? Or
I think
is it
it's
them?
A combination of them and the radio. I don't like it already. That's it, they suck. It sounds like the radio playing Fish, and then just chord music, but no tuba. Where the fuck's the tuba?
I bet your ruffles with ridges is playing the tuba.
You think so?
Yep.
Well, you gotta get that on tape.
I will.
I say tie in mesh hats a guitar player. Not a bass guitar player either. Maybe a rhythm guitar player. He might do a lot of singing too. Somebody else is in the door.
Drink.
It's like Seinfeld.
You do?
You ever notice what? I mean, do you ever notice what?
Dude, I'm getting paranoid.
But what?
No. They want to hear Freebird, man.
Shh, dang it.
We're down south. What are we doing down south?
Down south? You ain't been outside in 10 seconds, have you?
Oh. Man, I'm getting the hoobie jubies.
Just don't shit, man.
I'm getting the Stevie Weebies.
Just don't turd.
Oh.
Cause for a rabbit, man, you pretty.
I'm getting the cold shit.
You're pretty evil in that respect. You know what I'm saying? For a pretty little rabbit.
What's going on, man? So that it ain't right, man. It ain't right.
What do you mean it ain't right?
It ain't right, man.
Dude.
Yo, we're always like that.
Remember that? This ain't nerve as that acid you did. Remember that fucking shit green acid you got?
No, man.
What's up? How's it going?
It's going.
What's your name, little boy?
My name is, Dick.
Ah, Dick? You're making that up, Dick.
No, well, it's actually Richard.
Richard?
People call me Dick. So, it's kind of fucked up.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, man. Dick.
Sweaty pants dick.
My name's Wayne Nietzsche, and you're watching the I'm Going to Make a Drug with My Mind show on RCTV channel 15, cable, fancy like.
They were born here all along.
Yeah, it's not the same.
I meet lots of rabbits.
Yeah.
I'm not too proud to admit that I go to a pet shop every once in a while to meet other rabbits.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah. Well, you know.
The street rabbits are just not as, they're more pedigreed in the pet shop. It's more
the
ones
on the street?
About.
Hell yeah, yeah.
Right, they have more exposure to TV, etc. Yeah.
You got the blue eyes, though, so how come, where's your rabbit girl?
Huh?
Where's your rabbit girl? You know, you're like an old...
I've got
frustrated,
some...
blue eyes.
Well, I'm only 7 years old. Rabbit.
Thank you. starts to swell. Don't you hate it when that happens? Yeah, I hate it.
Zoopy goobies, man.
Why you want cookies?
Everybody wants
cookies. I want four or five cookies, man.
Yeah, right. We want to eat them.
We gotta corrupt the audience with cookies.
That's right. Where's your cigarette, dude?
I can't smoke a fucking cigarette.
I don't even recognize you, man.
Oh, tell me about it, man. I don't even smell the same.
What happened with that operation of yours, man?
Yeah, it's like I went straight after that.
Yeah, what, are you nuts? No. You go straight? Like, I know the doctor that worked on you. You know that, right? You know that, right? You know I know the doctor.
Yeah.
You thought it was me, but it wasn't me.
That's your twin brother, right?
Well, you know. You know how it goes, man.
He had more hair, that's for
sure. Well, he had a lot more hair. A lot more brains, too. He operated on you.
He's got that nurse.
Well, yeah, lucky bastard. He's grateful for that nurse, let me tell you.
I'm grateful for that
nurse. I'll bet. I bet you they're both grateful for that nurse. That's some nurse. Good night, nurse.
This band's really a...
They haven't played their first song. They're doing
that. I like it. It's sort of like The Residents, you know?
Oh, yeah. But this is sound check. Energy crisis. Boost energy crisis. Yeah.
myself, and I don't reckon that they hinder your health. You know, I've been smoking all of my life, and I ain't dead yet. But nicotine slaves are all the same. At a petting party or a poker game, everything's got to stop while they have that cigarette.
Smoke, smoke, smoke that cigarette. Puff, puff, puff.
And if you puff yourself to death, tell St. Peter at the Golden Gate that you just hate making way. But you gotta have another cigarette.
Comfort kid, thanks. I mean, my leg.
Getting picked by the rabbit.
I know. I'm kind of nervous. This place looks like a place where rabbits go to die. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
I know you know what I'm talking about.
But it can die.
I hope I'm not gonna die. You know what the hell.
You hope you won't die.
No, I won't.
Ah, Jesus. Yeah,
you want to get better, right?
Lots of drugs.
Better?
Clean and white.
Where did you get that impression?
Not for TV?
Yeah, not for puppet.
Well, this is where Miss Piggy went.
He's gonna, he can be okay.
It's good enough for Miss Piggy. It's good enough for me, right?
That's absolutely.
Ah, thanks. Thanks, kid.
See, everything's gonna be fine.
Yeah, everything's gonna be fine. It's easy for you to say, kid.
Yeah.
They're not cutting you open like a jack-o'-lantern, like they are me. I don't know, maybe nobody's home.
No, they're home. They get out here.
Well,
you shouldn't keep me waiting out here in the cold.
Let's go home. My lungs are feeling a lot better.
Everything is going to be okay. Hi, hi. We're just caught the rabbit here.
Yeah, hi.
Okay. I'm
feeling
much better. I don't know why we're waiting. Can we move this on?
All right.
Yeah, the fair sick rabbit.
Finally here.
Jesus.
Hi.
All right. I don't know about this.
Come on. I understand this place is the best.
I don't know.
How you feeling?
Yeah, I'm feeling great.
You look there, Studger. You look really nice.
Oh.
I'm feeling better about this, aren't you?
I think I just saw a rat.
I did not see a rat.
This is the attending physician. Dr. D.
Hi, how you doing?
Hello, Mr. Pot.
Hi,
make yourself comfortable.
What's the D stand for?
The D stands for diaphoresis.
Ah.
You're a joker, are you?
You're a Greek doctor.
That's right. So, we have,
don't bend over, whatever you do.
We have a condition that I'm seeing on your x-ray that is particularly abnormal for rabbits like yourself.
Right.
You've got, a bilateral lung condition that obviously was caused by years of smoking 10 packs a day.
Well,
is that about right?
I thought you'd go down to 7 at least.
I go a carton a day sometimes.
He's trying to quit. Filter.
I'm trying to quit. Christ, I'm a puppet. It don't matter. Right? I mean.
Well, unfortunately. We're going to have to refer you to a surgeon that'll help your condition out.
Well, what are you going
to
do to
I'd like to get this done right away, you know? Is there any way I can get on the table right away? As long as I'm here. Yep, we can schedule the room in 15 minutes, get you prepped up. And,
great.
Well, if that's the case, then maybe we'll just take off.
We can do
it.
Yeah.
We'll be in touch. Don't worry. Everything's going to be fine. We'll be here when you wake up. We promise.
He'll be in surgery for about 10 hours and then come back.
10 hours? I better get some good drugs for this. You know, this is great. I was kind of sketchy about this place, but you know, you seem to know what you're talking about. Not like some of the other quacks that I've met.
Yeah.
Not to bunch you in with the quacks, but you know, I was kind of worried about this place at first, but you know, you really know what you're talking about, it seems. And I've got a lot of confidence in you, Doc.
No, I appreciate that.
Hey, yeah, no problem.
Oh shit, it's 420. Sorry.
Yeah.
Morning, Earl. Sam, how you doing?
Good to see you.
How's the wife?
Excellent. Hey. You're not.
Hello, nurse.
Hey, Doc.
How are you?
Doing good.
You must be Pisspot the Rabbit.
Yeah, hi, I'm Pisspot the Rabbit. Where's Dr. D going? Yeah.
You must be Pisspot.
Yeah, Pisspot the Rabbit. Hi, how you
doing? Don't mind me, I'm a little punchy.
You're the janitor, eh?
Dr. D's leaving. What?
He's lumpectomy on me. Yeah.
Pisspot.
Who are you?
Rabbit?
Are you a janitor or something?
I am your surgeon.
Where's Dr. D?
It's 420. Dr. D is gone. I am your surgeon.
You know, what are you looking at that for? I think I gotta go home. Yeah, I got my toothbrush at home.
Pisspot the Rabbit, right?
Yeah, right.
Pisspot the Rabbit? Must be Pisspot the Rabbit, aren't you?
Yeah, Pisspot the Rabbit.
10-hour surgery?
10-hour surgery, yeah.
Friends just left?
Yeah.
Doctor just told you it'd be a long surgery?
Yeah.
Guess who's cutting you open? Smoking cigarettes? Ciggy smoker?
Here we could go. Gonna do a little bit of cutting, a little bit of surgery. Everything's gonna be just
go.
No, you'll be all right. You'll be all right, yeah. You'll be okay. You'll be okay, Pisspot. I swear, you'll be okay.
It'll be okay.
Just fine. Okay.
I gotta go.
No, you're not going anywhere. Remember, cut.
What are you doing?
We're gonna do a look. Cut.
No. I gotta.
I'm not going anywhere.
What's that for?
Good.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Wow. I don't know.
Wow.
What was that?
Whoa.
I got it.
Yeah, I found the gas, isn't it?
The rabbit here on the operating table. I'm a little nervous. How are we doing this? Am I getting a shot, like some morphine, or get some gas? I like the gas, personally.
Most people do like the gas.
Yeah, I used to have a canister of it in college, and I used to use it to relax all the time.
I'll bet. No, we're gonna use a little sodium pentothal hydrochloric acid just to put you out.
Hydrochloric acid.
Yeah, just a little bit of it, not very much. You're thinking more of the lysergic, some other type of acid you're thinking of.
Can I have some of that too?
Maybe when you wake up, but we're gonna give you look at the size of that. You're gonna get all that plus two more, and we know that you've been under a lot of stress. And a lot of drugs. And we understand that you're not like any other rabbit, so you need a maximum three times the normal dosage, okay?
Sock it to me, baby.
Okay, well, you say that now. Okay, here is the first one.
That tastes like shit.
Here is the second one. Here it is.
Okay, we're kind of seeing what's going on. It's, we know the lungs are tender. I mean, that goes without saying. And we gotta find what layer of this fur we can cut through to get through that first layer of skin. So here we kind of go right down the middle. We'll move a little fur here. Poor Pisspot is definitely under. He's not moving at all, which is a good thing. I think he's still breathing, which is good. We're gonna trim a little bit of this fur out of the way here. That's what's gonna happen. And we'll get a little more of this fur. He's a furry little creature, isn't he? He's a funny rabbit, that's what he is. Anyway, we gotta get this funny rabbit back to being a funny rabbit. So I'm gonna move a little bit of hair here and move it. Let's see. I think this is gonna be a good spot for the incision between the two lungs. Make sure we don't puncture it. Actually, I'm really trying to like this part. Oh, there's a little blood there. A little blood. Oh, I kind of like this part. Really, really, kind of. I really hate this part. Oh, I like this part. Really like this part. Right now, we got to really, really kind of get some of this blood out of here. We've created quite a mess. Oh, I hate this part. Oh, I'm ripping this skin back. I really hate this part. And we're going to have to see what condition the lungs are in. And look at it. Oh!
Ah, Jesus Christ! Oh, shit! Ah!
Easy.
Jesus!
Easy. Easy. Does it hurt when I do this? Thank you, nurse. Looks like it's kind of tough. Got to get through this muscle, through this backbone. Got to part of this. Let's see if I don't think I wasn't expecting that in there.
You're a buddy. Liver. I've seen it. I've seen it.
And let's see if I can get through the bottom layer of that stomach. Let's see if I can get to the stomach and find out really what the problem here is. I'm sure it's stomach related. Oh, that's what we found in Pisspot's stomach again. Okay, looks like there's some more. We gotta get near, right near the lungs. Sorry, nurse. Sorry.
I'm gonna call Peter. You get it?
Yeah, I get it. Peter.
Oh, shit.
Pisspot. We're gonna get right next to the lungs, Pisspot. He didn't jump too much. Good rabbit. He'll be okay. That little gurgling sound you hear is just Pisspot out breathing. And thank you, nurse. We're still having a problem. I wonder if this rabbit even has lungs at this point. Cotton swab.
I like my steak bread.
Excellent.
Hey, Doc.
Thanks, nurse. Thank you, nurse. And we are finally reaching the lung. This is Pisspot the Rabbit's. I really believe it's Pisspot's lung, folks. In you watching this documentary tape on Pisspot, this should be a lesson to all people that smoke. Look what your lungs turn into. This is one lung. If you're watching this documentary of a rabbit that smoked the better part of his life, Now, this is one lung. Look at this. Just, it's... Pisspot has no idea what he's really done to himself, but that's one lung. And had a lot of stomach to go through. We had a lot of the stomach. Nice cleavage, nurse. What'd you think, Pisspot?
Hey!
Never thought Pisspot would miss out on cleavage. It's almost hard to believe that a rabbit that smoked, pardon me folks, for getting a little excited for so long, could even, thank you nurse, even have lungs at this age. And, well, maybe parts of Pisspot's lung are now coming out in pieces. We're not going to be as fortunate with this lung as we were with the last one. This one is not going to be as pretty as the last one. You thought the last one, how this lung comes out. Thank you, nurse. You're not looking.
Hey, that's
cleavage nurse? Not you. Scalpel. Alcohol.
And rabbits, you know, sometimes suck up cigarette butts through osmosis, just inhale crazy things and they have to eat them. And oh, you gotta clean out this lung, and it looks as though Pisspot smoked menthols. He had a hankering for menthol cigarettes and American beer. No, here's two lungs. Now, you know, Pisspot probably, can't live very long without, Pisspot can't live without his lungs!
Gold and the ways of a gentleman, I've been told. The kind of a feller that wouldn't even harm a flea. But if me and a certain character met, that guy that invented the cigarette, well, I'd murder that son of a gun in the first degree. Now, it ain't cause that I don't smoke myself, and I don't reckon that they hinder your health. You know, I've been smoking all of my life, and I ain't dead yet. But nicotine slaves are all the same. At a petting party or a poker game, everything's got to stop while they have that cigarette.
Smoke, smoke, smoke that cigarette. Puff, puff, puff.
And if you puff yourself to death, tell St. Peter at the Golden Gate that you just hate the smoke.
Thank you.
I just open the sluices at both ends in disgust. It just makes Rochester seem like a half-ass city. If you're gonna censor it, be like Philadelphia. Just get rid of it, censor it. None of it's, oh, well, it's sort of offensive, so we're going to make a compromise and we'll cut half of it off.
Eugene, he will make it, man. He will not break it. He's starting a solution, man, to not only new opportunities for the land, man, people. Where's he at now, man? I like to talk with him. Get me on the station, man. Can you realize, hey, man, Eugene is something that he can make people over his eye unique.
That's
unique,
right.
Okay?
That's right.
Realizing that you've been paralyzing through Eugene, man, okay? He has the natural genes on. Hey, I'm paralyzed, man. Can you copy me? Hey, look, Eugene, hey, what do he realize? Where do he swim at, man?
Why should I pay any money for fucking Pisspot the Rabbit? Why does Pisspot the Rabbit have lung cancer? Because he smokes 80 zillion fucking cigarettes, that's why. It's his own goddamn fault.
Sort of got it by proxy, you know what I'm saying?
Do you know my friend Matt?
Yeah, so...
What? What?
See Sean at the bar and tell him who you're voting for.
Yeah,
that's right. So, sometime during the night, like on some channel, like this show comes up. Practicing smoking pot, actually smoking more pot, practicing.